Captain Davis.
Yeah, loved it. Star Trek Voyager, Tom Paris, that's me.
Oh,
yes. Lord, you probably don't even want to know.
But she's the mother. She's the mother, Tyler.
So you're the new kid in town in season 2.
It's me.
About your character. I haven't read the books.
Yeah, okay. Oh, wow. Okay. Well, you get to see her power suit this season, which is, from what I've heard and from what I've seen on Twitter and online and everything, the fans are really excited to see this suit, for sure. And you get to see a lot of action and her team. She has a special team that she is in charge of. She's a gunnery sergeant, and you get to see a lot of action sequences that they do. And then some stuff happens halfway through the season that just shifts 360 totally, and you get to see another side of it, which is cool.
You guys sometimes get depressed about the future. I mean, it's so downer. A lot of it is such
but
a downer.
But the present is...
It's such a downer. I mean, it's like, yeah. Oh, this is what we have to look forward to? I mean...
Well, I don't think any of us will be around in 200 years, so...
But we would love people to take it for, do not take it for granted and realize that if we're not smart enough to take care of Mother Earth, the future is going to be as gloomy.
Yeah.
That's, depends on your interpretation of the future. Popper decided that we were all going to live happily ever after. But did it happen? No. It's getting darker by the day. So
hopefully in the next season it'll be a little bit more optimistic, something uplifting.
It is more optimistic for the fact that the first season is about introducing these characters.
Right.
This season is about their relationship, interaction, how they intermingle, which is far more human and suggests a couple of ways to salvation. If you're smart enough, you should understand them.
You can only hope, huh?
Yeah.
Fingers crossed.
The future is now. If we take care of it now,
that's right.
Our the children of our children are going to live a happy life. Otherwise, it's going to get dark.
You mentioned you're the Martian gunnery sergeant.
Yeah,
I'm almost in the third book.
Oh yeah, I'm Bobby.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it's got to be great for you as an actress to do the strong woman. I mean, the one that's playing the hardball with the guys. I mean, it's very very different in the book itself too, and also in the character. So it's got to be a lot of fun for you.
I'm enjoying it. What's the term? Chewing it? Is it a chewing character? A chewing character. I love it.
If you're a walker on the field, you're a good
She exudes power, and no matter what. I have a feeling that when you have a mission, you have a goal, and you dedicate yourself to your goal and mission, then no matter what, you look powerful. Because you're a person with a reason to live for. It's not just, I'm having fun, let's just eat and have sex and this and that. It's about life, zest of life.
It's a political intrigue for you. The books are quite matching with the seasons because you can't get through the whole thing. But you do all the action stuff, at least to begin with, and you get to do all the political intrigue. So.
The brain, the philosophical part. And this year you see a lot of poetry.
What is it that attracts you to this genre? So what is it about this genre that attracts you so much?
Science fiction?
Yeah, because I was looking at you, I'm moving you so far.
I love science fiction and I love animations. With these two, you can talk about important stuff without getting people pissed off or offended, or you can just talk about reality in an obscure way and people would get the message.
And the fans are so loyal.
Did we get to see much of you without the uniform and
in
the armor?
She looks gorgeous.
You see the armor and then you see everyday Bobby, which is nice because I get a break from wearing that suit.
We take the armor away.
Yeah.
Do you work with stunt guys and ammunition guys?
No, I do all the stunts.
You do all the stunts?
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, she's always up in the air on the wires.
Running.
Yeah. Oh, that's what I mean.
I usually like to do the stunts. I'm naturally athletic, so that sort of stuff is
like
really
scary
exciting.
When you're way up there like that.
Is the creature CGI or is there somebody in a suit doing that creature?
CGI.
So is doing the stunts your favorite part of doing the show? Or?
I think I like it all. I really do. I like the broad spectrum of it. So it's just action and a whole bunch of other things. All right.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.